Select the button icon. Drag it by holding click to the place you want to place it. To edit the name, double-click on the text. Select the style icon. By clicking on this icon, you can customize the background color. By clicking on this icon, you can customize the color of the text. To return, click on the initial icons. By clicking on the bar, you can increase or decrease the size of the text. Clicking on the lock returns the numeric value of the font size to the standard value. The outer margin marks the distance from the edge of the element to the outside of it. From the borders control, the width, in pixels, of the component edges is managed, the top edge, bottom edge, left side border and right side border are handled. Border radius allows you to define how rounded the corners of your component will be. Click on the data icon. By clicking Enable Internationalization, you enable internationalization. When you click the arrow, it displays the local options. Dynamic loading allows you to give the appearance of loaded while assigning the final value to the element. When the switch is activated, when it is disabled, it loses that appearance, leaving the component in question in its original form. When you activate the is-hidden switch, the selected control hides but does not remove it from the interface. This means that the control still exists on the components that make up the interface but is not visible. When you click his icon, you can add an icon on the button. When you click on the icon option, the selected icon is displayed in the system paths. You can choose the system path icon. Select the function icon. Add an event, you can choose on press, triggered when pressed, on long press, triggered when the button is pressed over a period of time of 2 seconds, and on press out, this event fires the instant the button is depressed. Thank you for watching this video.